just 24 more shopping days till Christmas. And here's a holiday favorite to start your day off with a smile.
Deck the halls with boughs of holly.
Deck the halls already. Oh. It's gonna be a long month.
This one? Red up?
Wow, I didn't know anyone read newspapers anymore. The old school.
Well, I work for the paper, so I like to keep the illusion going.
Writer?
I wish. Copy editor.
I get all the news I need to know online.
Yes, they do such in-depth reporting on Facebook and Twitter.
Well, sometimes you need to know what your friends had for lunch.
This?
Medium drip room for milk, please.
House or Christmas blend?
What makes it a Christmas blend? Is it brewed by elves?
I don't know. It's just a thing for the holidays. People like it. You want it?
That's okay. I'll stick with the house.
Sure you don't want to roll the dice?
No. Not with my coffee. No. Oh, can I also get a multigrain gluten-free bagel? Exactly 1 tablespoon of light cream cheese. Thank you.
Wow, you are a thrill seeker.
And you got paint on your face and in your hair.
Answer to the profession. Artist. Hey, check the halls. That's my favorite.
That makes one of us.
Hi.
I'll take a Christmas coffee, please. Extra large.
Is that their Christmas blend?
Oh, hey, Hales. No, it's holiday-free coffee, thankfully.
Uh-oh, here it comes again. The I Hate Christmas blues.
You have such a vivid imagination. No wonder you work in the creative department.
You do realize it's been 2 Christmases since Steve proved what a worthless excuse for a boyfriend he was.
Isn't it time you gave the holidays a break?
I am overflowing with Christmas cheer. Hey, watch it with the reindeer.
You are so not overflowing with cheer.
I'm stressed. I'm meeting with a vet about my story pitch.
Oh, the one about the dog weddings. That's great. That must mean she really likes it.
Or she just wants to reject me face to face. Again.
I'm sorry, it's a pass.
Really? Because I feel like a lot of our readers who love dogs...
Susan, maybe you were just meant to edit other writers' work. There's no shame in that. It's a compliment.
Thanks, Yvette, but I'm tired of being a copy editor. I mean, I want to be a writer.
Well, then bring me an idea with some magic. Something authentic, emotional, personal. I mean, do you even have a dog?
No, but...
I rest my case. Susan? Okay, fine. I'm going to give you one more chance. Something just fell through for the Christmas Day edition. Pitch me an amazing holiday story, and the slot is yours. You are into Christmas, aren't you?
Christmas? Me? Are you kidding? I live for Christmas. I mean, I am the queen of Christmas.
Okay, outline on my desk in 2 days.
2 days. 2 days.
Bother with these lights. Half of them don't work. They always get tangled up, and you just end up throwing them out.
And buying new ones. It's just what we do, sweetie.
Well, it doesn't seem very practical.
You should write about this.
A story about an old piece of wood. I smell Pulitzer.
You can make jokes, but this old piece of wood is a story. One filled with magic.
Mom, please, not that again.
I'll be cynical, Susie, if you want, but this little angel brings people together.
Oh, hon, that's old family folklore.
How did you and I meet?
Was that a trick question?
You met on a blind date, so...
So what was I doing the first time your father called to ask me out? I was decorating the
family
Christmas tree.
We're literally placing the angel on top of it when the phone rang.
That's right. And 10 months later, I was walking down the aisle.
Mom, it's sentimental, but it's not a feature story. Thank you, though.
I tell you what. Take it. It's yours.
What? How is it mine? Don't I have to get married before the big angel passed down? Isn't that the family rule?
Rules are meant to be broken.
Since when?
Maybe the angel will help inspire your article.
Which is to say, help find you a boyfriend.
Preferably before the holidays.
Oh,
and someone special, please.
Thank you, Mom, but I'm not looking for someone special. Okay? Not right now, anyway.
Just might be up to this little angel here.
Oh. Got it. And then it seems my great-grandpa carved the angel for this actress he fell for. But in the end, he married my great-grandma Maggie and gave the angel to her.
You should at least write about it. Maybe the thing with your great-grandpa and the actress was really romantic. Or better yet, tragic.
Well, the problem is no one knows much about it. According to my mom, he never talked about the actress.
Well, maybe not to your mom. Look, you want to be a journalist, right? So go investigate. And would you please get that angel a Christmas tree? She works 1 month out of the year. Don't deprive her.
Even if I wanted to, I can't. Remember?
No backyard. All right, your wacky family custom. Outdoor Christmas trees only. Who started that brilliant idea anyway?
My great, great grandfather, ages ago in Wales. So the tree could look up to God.
That part's actually sort of nice.
Yeah, it is.
Sweetie, you nail this article. The sky's the limit.
Wow. You are an optimist.
Gotta think outside the box, sister. Pitch coming.
Oh, fabulous, Yvette. Fabulous. Can't wait for you to read it.
And I can't wait, period. If it's not on my desk tomorrow, I look elsewhere, understood?
Mm-hmm.
You know, for the Queen of Christmas, you're a little light on your decorations.
I read your pitch.
You hated it. Message received. Maybe I'm not meant to be a writer after all. You know what? That's okay. Because I'm thinking maybe I should just
Susan,
quit
I liked
together.
It. Just pack up myself. Wait, what? What did you just say?
I said I liked it. It's good. It's the perfect Christmas piece. It has hope, love, enchantment, and a teaspoon of mystery to polish it off. Best of all, it's true.
That I'm so glad.
Of course, you could drive a truck through the holes in the story. Number one, who was this actress your great-grandfather loved? And whatever became of her?
I will find out everything.
And I don't need to remind you that you need an ending. Angel comes full circle, family mystery solved, that sort of thing.
There's a great ending here. I know it.
3,000 words by December 24th.
Thanks, Yvette. Thank you.
So, how'd it go?
She actually used the word perfect.
Oh my gosh, that's fantastic.
See, I told you it would happen.
It's fantastic.
Susan's writing the new feature for the Christmas Day issue.
Ambitious. I like that. Congratulations.
Thank you. Right back at you, Mr. New Vice President of Advertising.
We should go out and celebrate our victories. Cafe Solana, tomorrow night.
Doesn't that place have like a 6-month wait?
The owner's an old family friend.
That's a really tempting offer, thank you, but I got a lot of work to do.
No problem. If you change your mind, let me know.
I've got a lot of work to do.
What? I can't go out with someone I work with.
Steve worked here.
And there you have it. I gotta go.
3,000 words to write.
How my great grandpa met this actress, who she was, why he carved the angel for her, and why they broke up. Piece of cake, right?
My money's on you. And the magic angel you carry around with you, of course.
Oh, stop it. I just didn't want to leave it at work. It's not magic.
Oh, I forgot. I promised I'd go to this gallery opening.
Wait, come with me.
What?
No, Haley, I have to get home and start my research.
Come on, it's right around the corner. 5 minutes.
No.
Come on. All right, you're coming with me.
But, no, you're coming with me.
This is interesting.
Look at this. Broadway Christmas, 1925.
That actress was probably starring in a play right then and there.
I never thought of them meeting in New York.
See how much more you already know?
Oh, look at this one.
This one's my favorite. Especially dig how the light is cast on the lovers' faces. It's all reflected in the store window's Christmas display.
Coffee shop guy?
Newspaper girl.
Wait, you two know each other?
No, not really.
Well, we crossed swords the other day at the brewing station because I like Deck the Halls and she does not.
Brady Howe,
assistant gallery manager and artist in residence. Mm. Oh, yikes, I'm sorry.
Hi, I'm Haley.
Hi.
Saw the nice man in your name, sweetie.
Oh, Susan. Susan Nicholas, hello.
So, artist in residence. What does that mean exactly?
Basically means that the gallery owners let me use their storeroom to work on my masterpieces. That is when I'm not hosting gallery openings and giving my 2 cents about what's hanging on the walls.
Your masterpieces.
Well, you gotta aim high. Anybody want a guided tour?
Yeah, it's just so late, so I feel like I
we'd love one.
Yes?
Awesome. Follow me.
Right.
And this one is called Christmas at the White House, 1955, even though it's really just a White House in Ohio somewhere. But what's cool about it is the way that the light lands in a way.
Looks like it's daytime above the house, but nighttime below.
Exactly.
Haley, we really have to go.
But Brady's not done yet. Are you, Brady?
Honestly, I could talk about this stuff for days, so you should probably get out of here while you have the chance.
Okay, well, thank you for the tour. You are a wealth of information.
It was a pleasure. There's one important thing I don't know, though.
What's that?
Whether or not I could take you for an adult drink sometime. Martini, wine, eggnog, if you're into the whole seasonal beverage thing. Please don't make me drink alone.
Does that wine really work for you?
I don't know, does it?
Not so much.
Pity. I'm excellent company.
Taxi! Are you insane? He was adorable. I don't trust artsy types.
I'm an artsy type. Are we dating?
You're not dating anyone. There is nothing on earth that could make me consider that idea.
Hey. What? Sorry for invading your umbrella space. You, forgot this in the coat room.
Oh. Thank you.
No problem. Nice meeting you.
Absolutely nothing on earth, huh? She's coming. Oh, coming.
I see someone's getting her caffeine fix.
Hi, Derek. Yeah, 3 o'clock rolls around and it's either this or a power nap.
Since no one ever got a raise by dozing in their cubicle.
Say no more. I'm with you. How's your Christmas story going? You all swept up in the holiday spirit?
Not sure swept up would exactly describe it. Anyway, I'm still in research mode. How about you? Are you a holiday kind of guy?
Can I be completely honest with you? I'm not a big fan of Christmas or New Year's.
Really?
It all feels so forced and manufactured. I mostly can't wait for the week to pass so that I can get back on schedule and back to work. And I know it's early December, but if I have to hear Deck the Halls one more time, I can't be responsible for my actions.
A man after my own heart. I mean, I feel your pain. Hey, enjoy your coffee.
Sees all and knows all.
Oh, if you believe in angels.
Let me guess, you don't.
Let me guess, you do.
Well, in art, angels are everywhere, so it was hard not to.
So what are you doing here other than window watching?
Actually, I was about to pop in somewhere warm. You up for that drink?
Oh, no, I have to get home. Work to do for tomorrow.
Yet here we are. You, me, an angel, something going on. Come on, one drink. Then you can go back and be the responsible employee.
You know, you have paint on your nose. Kidding.
And I take that as a yes. Hi, Warren Zakakos to be hired.
Best Irish coffee in the city.
Sorry, it's a little crazy in here. I've got a lot on my mind.
But it needs to relax sometimes.
That's not a word on my schedule right now.
Is it ever?
Hey, with all due respect, you don't know me.
No, I'm trying to. Can you give me a hand here?
Fine. I'm kind of stressed out about this Christmas article I'm doing.
So you're writing, that's great. Your wish came true.
I feel like I'm driving without a map. I mean, I know where I have to go. I just don't know how or even if I'll get there.
Enjoy the ride. The destination will unfold.
And did you just make that up now or steal it from an old Star Trek?
It was funny.
So, tell me about your art. What are you working on?
Oh, all kinds of stuff. Portraits, landscapes, abstracts, sculptures, mosaics, mixed media, you name it.
Wow, at least you narrowed it down.
Choice is one of life's great luxuries.
You think you'll choose to run your own gallery one day?
No idea. I had a buddy, Zach. He found a space a while back. He thought we could go in on one together, but I don't know. I want to create. I want to stay liberated.
Yeah. But think about it. If you had your own gallery, you could show your work without anyone else's permission. That's liberation.
Good, right?
It's not bad.
Well, if it doesn't work out with your article, at least you have Christmas to look forward to. Okay.
Let's just say I have a complicated relationship with Christmas.
Have you seen a couples counselor?
I tried. Santa kept missing the appointment. Something about his busy season. I don't know.
Oh, I'm all about Christmas.
Yeah, you should be my mother. On second thought.
Hey, what are you doing tomorrow night?
Brady, this was nice. I mean, you're interesting. I just don't have room in my life right now.
I just asked you what you're doing tomorrow night. How do you know? Maybe I'm taking a poll. What are you doing tomorrow night?
Thanks for the drink.
Bye, Brady.
See ya.
Susie Q.
Hi, Grandpa. Sorry I'm late.
I'm just glad you made it. I was afraid you might need a passport to come all the way out to Long Island.
Well, I don't know exactly what I'm looking for anyway. Just some history of great-grandpa Owen's life. Whoa.
Like my organizing system?
You really don't throw anything away, do you?
Mm-hmm. Ever since your grandma Rose passed, I kind of just let things pile up. Your great-grandpa Owen's stuff should be in one of these boxes. Not there. Oh, boy. I haven't seen this thing in ages.
I remember that.
It's Grandma's favorite. She painted it herself.
Well, her family loves its angels, huh?
Oh, yeah. Does your mom still have a family angel?
Actually, she gave it to me. It's kind of what got this whole thing started.
Yeah. Yeah, my dad was so proud of that thing. He used to say it was made with love. He carved it back in 1926. He spent weeks working on it, as I recall. He wanted to get every detail just right.
Did he ever talk about the woman he carved it for? That actress?
The actress? Of course. Fashioned the angel after her. Especially the eyes. At least, that was what he told us.
Any idea how they met?
Yeah, actually, I do know. It was Christmas time. I want to say around 1925. My father took a trip into Manhattan. And one night, he went to see a play on Broadway. And it was there that he laid his eyes upon the most beautiful woman he had ever seen. She was an actress performing in the play that night. I remember him telling me about her long golden hair and beautiful lavender eyes. He said it looked as though she were sent from heaven.
Yes, may I help you?
I'm Owen Thomas. I'm visiting from Bethlehem, Pennsylvania.
Oh, thank you.
Please don't be taken aback, but I loved your performance this evening. And I also happen to think you're the most beautiful woman I've ever seen.
Well, that's quite a declaration, Owen Thomas from Bethlehem.
I know. And I realize it's Christmas week, but if you have any free time, I'd be honored if you'd spend it with me while I'm here in New York.
Wow. That was a pretty bold move.
Must have worked, because she said yes.
Unlike me, who would have filed a restraining order.
Never turn your back on love, Susie Q.
You wouldn't happen to remember the actress's name, would you?
Nope. Can't say that I do. My father said they wrote to each other for about a year, but that was it. He never mentioned it again.
Really?
Yeah. In fact, it usually took a couple of slugs of scotch from him to bring it up in the first place. Sorry, it's such a mess.
So, do you think our family angel has magic powers? Mom seems to think it's the next best thing to having a matchmaker.
You know how I met Grandma Rose, don't you?
In a supermarket, right?
Mm-hmm. Hardware store.
Oh.
On Christmas Eve, I dropped the angel and broke its nose. When I went out to get some wood glue, who was in the next aisle buying Christmas lights? Only the prettiest gal I'd ever seen. Mm-mm. Coincidence? Special powers? Who knows? But I'm sure glad I dropped the darn thing. That moment changed my life.
How's the busiest bee in the hive?
Q-tie. What's the occasion?
It's wining and dining some prospective advertisers. Big spenders. Could help me reach my annual goal.
Goals are good.
Well, I've got a million of them.
Really? Name three.
Make SVP by next year. Buy a condo. Meet the woman of my dreams.
And that shouldn't be too hard for you.
It is when she's too busy to go out with me.
I meant, like, to buy a condo.
What's with them? All the angels.
Yeah, they're for this article I'm writing. Long story.
All the angels, I believe, and playing the baseball team. My offer to celebrate still stands, you know. You go out or stay in. I cook a superb branzino.
Well, I love branzino, but I love my job more. I need to focus on this.
Gotcha. But we all have to eat, so call me when you come up for air, okay?
Maybe.
I already know what you think I should do. Back to the scene of the crime.
Interesting choice of words. Glad you came. Why did you?
I thought maybe if I did, you'd finally leave me alone.
This is as good a reason as any.
So why am I here again?
You, my new student, desperately need your Christmas spirit back. And I'm going to be your guide to all things Yuletide.
What if I say no?
Well, then you never get rid of me. Unless you change your cell phone, that might work too.
Where are we going?
It's a surprise.
Oh, no. I'm not big on surprises.
Shocker. Well, kiss that boring chapter of your life. Goodbye.
This is why I hate surprises.
Why? Because you might have fun?
No, because I'm a total klutz.
Oh, come on. You're doing awesome.
Yeah. I think I'll quit while I'm ahead.
Here, just take my hand. Oh, who's got commitment issues? Ooh.
Brady, this isn't the class I signed up for.
What about your Christmas spirit?
The world will live without it.
Yeah, but will you?
What's that, your guardian angel?
Oh my gosh, Derek, I'm so sorry. Are you okay?
Boy, I don't think that angel likes me.
Can I get you a tissue or something?
No, it's okay, it's fine, really. Oh, great. Coffee and my brand new Hugo Boss tie. Is $100 down the drain?
Listen, I will pay for that dry cleaning.
Susan, you can't dry clean a tie. They're never the same. What are you doing with that thing anyway?
It's being photographed for my article. Listen, I said I was sorry. Susan, good you're here. We're all set up for the... What happened to you?
Well, you could say I was touched by an angel.
Clumsy one from the looks of it. We're shooting in my office.
Okay, I'll be right there.
I just wanted to look good for my new client meeting today. I know it was just an accident.
Then again, maybe there are no accidents, huh? Mom, come on. You can't really believe the angel was trying to tell me something.
Do you like this, Derek?
Might. I don't know, maybe a little, but since the tie incident, I'm not so sure.
Well, angels see all and know all.
That's exactly what Brady said.
Smart man.
Who's Brady? He's this artist I met.
Really? Do you like him?
Mom, I barely know him.
That wasn't what I asked.
Well, I'll say this, he's different.
Now that sounds promising.
Okay, you're just saying that because he's male and breathing.
No, I'm saying it because nothing would make me happier than to see my only daughter happy. And don't thank me, it's my job.
So, were you surprised to get my text?
Probably not as surprised as you were that you sent it.
Please. I had a little writer's block. I thought it might be good for me to get out.
Fair enough. So, how did you remember that you used to make your own Christmas ornaments? Was that hypnosis? Regression therapy?
Photographic memory. My mother's.
Well, what better place to revisit your glory days of ornament making than an art studio? Especially one that comes with its very own artist.
A talented one at that. Why didn't you tell me you were so good?
Oh, probably all kinds of things we haven't told each other.
Worst part was, he left me for our yoga instructor. Here I was thinking, oh, so great, Steve and I have so much in common. We even both love yoga. Little did I know what he loved was the teacher.
It's a bummer. At least he left you for a person, though. My last girlfriend, Anna, she said that she would rather be alone than be with me.
Oh, that's awful. You're not that bad.
Gee, thanks.
I'm guessing she didn't dump you on Christmas Day.
He did?
Yeah.
Yeesh, that's low. No wonder you're so weird about Christmas.
I've always been kind of funky about the holidays. All that pressure to enjoy yourself.
Yeah, I know, it's such a chore.
After Steve went into overdrive.
Well, when Anna left me, I was a mess, but I realized it wasn't really her that I missed that much. It was just being part of a couple, you know, a team. So I just told myself I'm gonna go out and find someone better.
Oh, that's impressive. Me, I just turned in my yoga mat, called it a day.
Oh. Yoga's boring anyway. Nobody talks. Rule number one, no rulers.
What? Why? I don't want a lopsided gingerbread house.
Just eyeball the pieces and glue them together. It's not supposed to be perfect. It's supposed to be handmade. See?
No, see, that's just goofy.
I know, right? So, I was thinking about what you said about running my own gallery. Kind of makes sense.
And you're not worried this may qualify as an actual life plan?
No. No make plans. I
envision.
Well, I stand corrected.
Miss Neat, you got a little spot of paint on your face there.
Where?
Just
here. Yeah. Here.
There. Here. There you go. Good as new.
Thanks. From? Sorry I snapped. Please forgive me, Derek. Nice move. Point Derek. I saw Brady again yesterday. Point Brady. And nothing. We made Christmas ornaments.
And
he and his favorite bottle of wine are coming over later. I have no idea what I'm doing. You don't have to know. You're just hanging out. This is good.
It is? Mm-hmm. Because it's feeling a little whirlwind to me.
Yeah? Lucky you. Grandpa, everything okay? Spring cleaning in December?
I figured your grandma's been gone 3 years now. She would have wanted me to downsize a bit. Must say it was quite the trip down memory lane.
What, Grandpa? How in the world did you do this?
Well, the neighbor kid needed some Christmas money, so I hired him as my assistant. Don't tell anyone, but he did most of the work. I found this box stuck in a corner. Just a bunch of old ledgers and invoices. But there was also this.
A blueprint?
Yeah.
Of what?
As soon as I saw it, I remembered a whole other part of that story my father told me. Want to hear?
Yes, I want to hear.
Well, that first Christmas week in New York, before my dad went back home, he came up with a plan.
Next Christmas, I'd like to come back to New York and bring you home with me to Bethlehem.
Oh, and that's a whole year away. And what exactly will you be doing all that time?
Building a cabin for us. With a Christmas tree outside the front door.
Owen, that sounds so beautiful. And I'm so flattered, really and truly. But my life is here, in New York.
Maybe so. And I know you love what you do. But next year at this time, I'm hoping you'll say yes.
And this was his design for the cottage?
Drew it himself. See his initials here in the corner?
Yeah. Did he ever build it?
Well, if he did, I never saw it. Oh, and I found something else. My parents' wedding picture.
What a lovely couple. Yeah. Your mother was so beautiful.
As beautiful inside as out. That's what my dad used to say.
She'd have to be to accept that angel he carved with his ex-girlfriend's eyes.
In fact, it was because of my mom that he even kept the angel.
How do you mean?
Well, if I remember correctly, it was on the day they first met at their church back in Bethlehem.
Excuse me.
Hello. Can I help you?
Is Pastor Boyd here?
No, I'm Maggie, the new church secretary.
Well, Maggie, I'd like to give this angel to the church for their Christmas tree. It's top quality, handmade.
Let me guess, by you?
How did you know?
The way way you're holding her. So proud, like she's part of you.
Well, she was, but not anymore. Would you like her?
It's very generous, and I'm sure Pastor Boyd would be grateful. But just between us, why would you want to give away something so beautiful? You should keep her. She'll bring you luck.
She already has. Bad luck.
Can I make a suggestion?
Owen Thomas.
Okay, Owen Thomas. Here's what I think. Why not keep the angel until next Christmas? If she doesn't bring you better luck, then you can come back and leave her here with us.
Something tells me my luck is changing already.
And it sure did. 6 months later, they were married.
So I guess you could say the angel brought them together. I mean, sort of, in a way.
Honey, take it from your old grandpa. If you want to believe, you have to take a leap. But look too close, and the magic's gone. Really, where's the fun of that?
Blueprint aside, it's just random stuff. No clues about the actress. Unless this carburetor receipt from 1958 has some hidden meaning.
Oh, looky here. Baby Susie with great-grandpa Owen. You're adorable. Of course.
He died when I was 2. I just wish I could have gotten to know him.
Yeah, he could have told you about the actress firsthand, saved you all the research.
Right now, I just settle for knowing her name.
I used to have an old relative that acted in the theater, too. According to my parents, anyway.
Yeah, I think every family has at least one starry-eyed member who tried acting at some point.
Yeah, look at this.
Opening night crowd enjoys the Christmas surprise.
December 3rd, 1926.
His second Christmas in New York.
Wait, is that? I think that's my great-grandfather.
Well, at least we know he was there.
We still don't know the name of the actress he fell for.
We'll Google the title, see what comes up.
Christmas surprise. Premiered on Broadway in 1926 at the Orpheum Theater in Manhattan. That's all it says. It's a dead end.
Not necessarily. That theater's still there. Might be worth a visit.
Radio. You're a genius. I mean, thank you.
Anytime.
All Austrian crystal.
Wow, it's just beautiful.
One of the oldest theaters on the Broadway.
Really?
Now, as I told you on the phone, Miss Nicholas, we're very proud of our history here at the Orpheum Theater.
So you think you can help me?
I know I can. If we're going to find anything, it'll be in this.
How long have you worked here at the theater?
All my life.
Really?
Yes. I started as an actor, you know? Now, here we go. 1926.
Right.
This is October, November, December. So what's in here?
Wait, there.
Oh. Ah.
A Christmas surprise. Wow. No wonder my great-grandfather was crazy about her.
She was a beauty. Jessica Rose. The girl with the lavender eyes.
Did the girl with the lavender eyes ever truly consider a life with the Pennsylvania coal miner? Did she ever really see beyond the lights of Broadway to ponder a future with someone as kind and loving and true as her unexpected admirer? Readers are going to eat this up. It's so emotional, so romantic. Yet, with a zippy Yuletide twist. Oh, and get this. The angel's eyes. Lavender, just like Jessica's. Sweet or creepy? Totally sweet. Meanwhile, how's the boy with the hot hazel eyes? How do you remember what color Brady's eyes were? You see, they have these little gold flecks in them.
How close to them did we get?
What? I need a refill.
Is all forgiven, or am I still an idiot?
Forgiven. At least by me. I can't vouch for her.
Put in a good word for me, would you? Just in case.
Will do. Thank you, by the way, for those flowers. They're gorgeous.
My sentiments exactly.
Oh. What was that?
What? What was what? You tell me, Flirty McFlirt. What about Brady and his gold flex?
Brady and I are just hanging out. You said it yourself.
Which makes Derek, what, some handy diversionary tactic?
See, there goes that vivid imagination of yours again.
Now, choosing a Christmas tree is one of the most important decisions of the holiday season.
So, which tree has your name on it?
Which one doesn't? Although I do have to go small, you know, apartment living.
Hmm. Well, if I was getting a tree, it'd be that one. Put my great-grandpa's angel right on top.
Oh, yeah? Your angel might find a home this Christmas.
Oh, no, no. You're not talking about that little Charlie Brown tree, are you?
Actually, I was thinking it would look awesome on the tree outside our country house.
You have a country house? Ah. La-di-da.
Relax. It's my parents, and it's more of a cabin. My great-grandparents bought it ages ago as a vacation place.
Sounds nice, is it?
It's totally nice. Just a few hours west of here, Murfreesboro, Pennsylvania.
Ah.
We should go. Christmas Eve.
What? No. My articles due that day. And anyway, I'm not going away with you. I've known you for all of what, 2 weeks?
Well, by then it'll have been 23 days, which is the lifespan of a worker bee.
Oh, wow. Thank you for that old factoid and for the offer, but I will pass.
Okay. Guess I'll just have to figure out something else closer to home. Think this will fit in the back of an Uber?
I think it could fit in the glove compartment.
That's very funny for someone who managed to get out of their Christmas tree last.
Hello, these bags weren't going to carry themselves.
Susan?
Oh, hey.
Hey.
Derek, what are you doing here?
I just made an offer on a condo around the corner.
That's fantastic.
You two look like you've been doing some shopping yourselves.
Yeah. Well, Brady, this is Derek. We work together. Derek, meet Brady. What do we do?
We know each other. It's actually pretty entertaining.
It's quite the fashion statement.
Oh.
Yeah, it's all part of Operation Jumpstart.
Which is?
It's Brady's personal mission to revive my Christmas spirit.
That's a joke, right?
No, it's as real as the Santa's on that scarf.
It's complicated.
I'm sure it is.
Not really.
Hey. Good luck with your condo. Okay. See you at the office, okay?
Merry Christmas. Wow. Should I be jealous?
Of who?
The, male model-looking condo-buying office guy that has zero appreciation for Christmas wear?
Well, I don't know. That depends. What exactly are we? Aside from two people who annoy each other.
Well, more than that, I hope. Don't you?
You're right. He has no appreciation for Christmas wear. Whatsoever.
Okay, so why are we on your roof?
Okay, what? We have this weird tradition in my family, right? We only put our Christmas trees outside. Idea is that it helps them look
up to God. Brady, this is unbelievable. My family has the same tradition.
Come on, no way. That's crazy.
No, we've done it forever. I just thought it was an old Welsh custom.
Well, apparently a few Irishmen picked it up along the way. Anyway, that's why the small tree. Because anything bigger would blow over up here. Makes sense?
about as much sense as anything right now.
To attend the opening night of a new play called The Christmas Surprise.
Owen, you made it! I'm just in time. Curtain is in 20 minutes.
You made this yourself? For me? It's gorgeous. And the eyes, they're lavender, like mine.
They're all I could see while I was carving it. You don't have a Christmas tree in here, I'm surprised.
Someone once told me that the only place for a Christmas tree is outside. Where
it can look up to God. Well, marry me. And every year, the angel will crown the tree in front of our new house.
10 minutes, Miss Rose.
You don't have to decide now. Go, have a magnificent opening night. We'll talk after.
So, who was your friend?
Derek, you scared me.
Sorry. I was saying, who was your friend? From yesterday.
Oh, Brady. He's an artist. And a holiday enthusiast.
Man.
And what?
Susan, I thought you were on a deadline.
I was. I am.
But dating's not quite as out of the question as you thought.
Brady and I aren't exactly dating.
Good. Then you and I can revisit the idea of dinner. Or even do something Christmassy, if that helps your little experiment.
Oh. I'll let you know, okay?
Fine. But I gotta tell you, that angel.
Why would you order a backup feature from another writer for my Christmas Day slot?
Just in case.
In case of what?
Susan, you've edited your share of backup articles. You know how this works?
Yvette, I've got this. You don't need a backup.
Oh, really? What if you don't find your ending? Then what?
Who says I don't already have it?
Do you?
Not completely, but I will, no question.
Excellent. Then you have nothing to worry about.
From now on, it is all writing, all the time. In fact, I'm gonna call Brady and tell him I can't see him tonight. We'll have to go caroling another time.
No.
Right now, being around Brady is the best thing for you and your article.
How do you figure that?
Susan, if you want to be a great writer, you have to experience life. And it's been a while since I've seen you this happy.
Really?
Yes, really. You've even got this bounce when you walk and your skin, it's glowing like it was lit by birthday candles.
Okay. That's ridiculous.
No, I'm serious. Brady's bringing out your creative side.
Heedless of the wind and weather, la 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 la.
Cheers, you guys. I think somebody has officially found their Christmas spirit.
That was actually really fun. Thank you.
For the record, you crushed Deck the Halls.
Yes.
And there's nothing silent about your silent night.
Oh, unlike you sing louder than me. I don't think somebody. Hey, oh, want to stop for one of those best Irish coffees in all of Manhattan? My treat.
How about someplace more private?
Okay.
To Saint Nick and the sled he rode in on.
Mm-hmm. You working on something new?
It's just something I'm messing around with.
Yeah? Can I take a look?
Yeah, no, maybe when I'm finished.
Okay.
So, you remember the friend of mine, Zach, was telling you about? He was looking for gallery space?
Yeah.
Well, he started looking again, and he found what he thinks is a primo spot.
I like what I'm hearing.
Yeah, he'd put the money up. I'd run the place. We'd split the profits.
Oh, this is fantastic. Where is it? Soho? Chelsea? Wait, Brooklyn?
Los Angeles.
Los Angeles?
Place called Echo Park. Real hip. Place needs a ton of work, but that's why we can do the lease.
Wow. California.
Yeah. Honestly, I had no idea where he was looking. I just assumed it was New York. Apparently, the worst dump is, like, through the roof here, so...
Brady. This is huge. Running a gallery in L.A., think about the work you can do out there. I mean, the weather alone should inspire greatness. Congratulations. When do you leave?
Believe me, I'm not even sure I want to do this thing.
Well, how could you not? It sounds perfect.
What if I was trying to leave myself open for other things?
Like what? This could be the chance of a lifetime. You don't want to blow this.
If you're talking about us, I agree.
Brady, you're a talented artist. You should put the work first. You have to put your work first. As for us, who knows what we are?
Look, you're a writer. I get that, you're all about the words, but not everything has to have a label. I think we started something really good here. I think it can only get better.
Yeah, maybe. But I'd feel terrible if you didn't move because of me. You can't do that. What?
Truth? I was kind of hoping that you were going to try and talk me out of this.
How about we table this conversation for now? Just finish up our work and enjoy the holidays.
Together?
Yeah, together.
Well, Brady, we're thrilled you could join us tonight. We thought we'd never meet you.
Yeah, I have to excuse my wife, Brady. When it comes to matters of the heart, she's incorrigible.
No worries. It's good to finally meet you. Stoked to help you decorate this tree.
And outdoors, too. Just like your folks do it, right?
Yeah, that's a crazy coincidence, huh?
Or not. Who knows? Brady, there's some cider on the stove. Would you mind getting it for us?
Yeah, sure.
Thank you. Oh, I love him.
I like him too, Stairs.
Honey, what's wrong?
I told Brady we could spend the holidays together, but now I'm thinking maybe we shouldn't. I don't want us to get too close. I mean, if he goes to L.A., that'll be it. So what's the point?
Yeah, logically speaking, I can't disagree.
Honey, if you and Brady are supposed to be together, it may already be out of your hands.
Well, please, I need a real answer.
So look, when the time comes, I mean, if it comes, make the decision together.
Okay. Who wants some cider?
I want some cider.
All yes, right. Sir.
Thank you.
You.
Thank you. Aw, this is so nice.
Merry Christmas.
Does eating dessert always make you this happy?
That's part of it. Okay, listen, I told Zach I'm out of the L.A. deal. If he wants to do it, he's on his own.
Brady, that's crazy. I told you you can't not go because of me.
No, you said that you'd feel terrible if I didn't go because of you, but then I realized that I'd feel terrible if I did go, so it's on me. What?
I thought we weren't going to get back into this until after the holidays.
Well, Zach was pushing me for a decision, so I made one.
Well, we should have made it together.
Why, so you could talk me out of it again?
Brady, you don't know me well enough or long enough to make such a major life choice like this.
Okay, so tell me everything I need to know about you. Don't leave anything out.
It's not that simple.
See, I think it is.
Yeah, because you're more free-spirited than I am.
A free spirit?
That's not a criticism.
You ever think that maybe you're not free-spirited enough?
Only every single day of my life, which is probably why I think you could be good for me.
Just not good enough.
If I thought that, I wouldn't even be here right now. Which I probably shouldn't be. I should be home finishing my article.
Yeah, maybe you should be. Or maybe you should take a cue from your great-grandfather who fell for somebody that he'd only known for a week.
Yeah, and I think you know how well that turned out. Brady, wait. Maybe we should just slow down a little. Take some time.
Just like that? What about the holidays?
I'm sorry, I just think it's for the best.
Okay. Just know that that jerk that dumped you on Christmas Eve for his yoga teacher, I am not that guy.
I'm sure Brady will accept your apology in a second. My apology? For what? Thinking of his future and trying not to hold him back?
I need my article. It's due tomorrow. I still have an actual ending to the Owen Jessica saga.
Couldn't you just make something up? I mean, who's gonna know?
You can't make up the facts. That's called fiction.
I call it flexibility. But hey, that's me. As for Brady, I'm not sure what your problem is. Who wouldn't want a guy who puts her first?
It's too much, too fast, and I don't trust it. But hey, that's me. More wine? Yes, please. So, I...
Evening, ladies.
Hi.
Where's your, artist friend?
We're taking kind of a timeout.
From what? Not exactly dating?
That sounds about right.
If you're gonna ask her to dance, would you do it already? Otherwise, we're getting a refill.
Sure. Okay. Care to dance?
Sure.
Perfect timing.
Angels we have heard on high, really.
You can't get away from Christmas, especially at a Christmas party. Good news. They accepted the offer of my condo. I close next month.
Wow. Look at you knocking down those goals like bowling pins.
The place looks great. I can't wait for you to see it.
Maybe it was. I don't know. Derek, I'm so sorry. I have to go. Sorry.
You having a good time?
Yeah, you'll have my article right on schedule tomorrow, 4 p.m.
Just so you know, the backup piece came in, and it's pretty terrific. But I'm expecting yours to be even better.
Got your tea.
Thanks.
Oh. I know this isn't news, but
Relationships are hard. And don't even get me started on marriage.
I just wasn't ready for this.
Well, I mean, who's ever ready for love? No? It happens. You know, it finds you, you jump in the deep end and swim for dear life.
What if you drown?
Sweetheart, did I ever tell you that your mother and I almost split up that first Christmas Eve that we spent together?
Really? She always says how you two were crazy about each other right from the start.
Oh, yeah, we were. Opposites tracked and all that. But you know what? We were both jockeying for control. We had different priorities, different approaches. And on that particular night, our own ways of decorating a Christmas tree.
Uh-oh. Mom and her Christmas tree.
Oh, yeah. I wanted to start at the top and work down. She wanted to start at the bottom and work up. And that was just the start of it. You know, there was the lights, the tinsel, the number of ornaments, the kind of ornaments. I mean, we disagreed about absolutely everything. We were both so set on our own family traditions. And I mean, an outside Christmas tree, what was that? Well, that was the last straw is what it was. We had a huge fight. And I got in my car and I just drove off. And I really had no idea if I was ever coming back.
But you did.
Yeah, about an hour later. But we never talked about it. We just finished decorating the tree. And then together, we put your great-grandfather's angel right on the top. You know what? Suddenly everything was okay. So, I don't know. Maybe there is something about that angel of yours.
Hmm. I never knew that story. What exactly are you trying to tell me?
He's trying to tell you that running away isn't always the only option. Isn't that right, darling?
Yes, of course, darling.
In the end, Owen and Jessica clearly made a decision about their future.
But how? And did they regret it forever? Or did they stand by their choices?
Going? His cabin.
One crisp blend, extra large.
family cabin is?
Susan?
Oh, hello. Hi. Merry Christmas Eve.
What are you doing here?
You said Murfreesburg, so I asked in town, and they directed me here. This place is lovely, by the way.
For somebody that doesn't like surprises, you sure know how to give one.
You mean like the angel painting? That was amazing. Thank you.
You're welcome. You know, you could have just texted me thank you, though. Save yourself the trip.
Yeah, well, it's Christmas Eve. Friends shouldn't let friends be alone. Yeah.
Come on.
I went to the market earlier, got some groceries, because the whole starving artist thing's a little overrated.
Why did you really come out here, Susan?
Brady, you were right. You're not Steve, not even close. But you're also not like most other guys I meet, and for someone like me, that's scary. And you throw in my Christmas angst and your whole New York, LA thing, there's so many roadblocks.
What if I told you I was rethinking Zach's offer? Maybe going out west after all.
I'd say that's great. Do it and we'll play it out. But for now, let's just have a fantastic Christmas Eve together.
Wow. You're okay with not having a plan for us, I mean?
I still don't have an actual ending for my article, but I'm turning it in anyway. So, yeah. Yeah, I guess I am okay. You?
For a free spirit, I am feeling weirdly grounded.
I have to at least try to wrap this thing up. I'm just gonna go grab my laptop.
There's a really cool desk you can work at in here. Been here for ages. Used to belong to my great grandma.
That's perfect. Brady? Brady, you out there? To someone who will one day write our story.
Were you calling me?
Yeah. Sorry, I was trying to find a pen and,
It's your address to my great-grandma Mabel in Manhattan.
Your great-grandmother's name was Mabel McNutt?
Yeah, it was her maiden name. I'm sure she couldn't wait to change it.
Well, I would. Wait, this one's postmarked Bethlehem, PA. They all are. Brady, that's where my great-grandfather was from.
Really? That's weird. What's wrong? Owen Thomas, 10 Sycamore Circle, Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. Is that...
Why would your great-grandpa be writing letters to my great-grandma?
Because she was your old relative who acted in the theater, who had the world's least glamorous name for an actress. So she changed it to Jessica Rose. Brady, do you realize what this means?
That your great-grandpa and my great-grandma were once in love?
Something tells me we were supposed to find these letters.
Well, go ahead, read one.
Yeah?
Yeah.
My darling Mabel, he called her Mabel, not Jessica. It is with a heavy heart that I am forced to say goodbye to you forever.
When you said accepting the angel would mean accepting me as your husband, and that your true heart was in the theater, I was crushed. But hard as it is to admit, I now wonder if that was a sign, maybe even from the angel herself, that we are not destined to be together, and that even greater love awaits.
Brady, this is the cottage he built for your great-grandmother. Get that old blueprint we saw. Looks like she found the place after all.
And made it a home away from home for her and great-grandpa Hal.
For generations to come.
So let's see. Owen and Mabel both fell in love again. They both had great families. And both lived happily ever after.
Yeah.
Looks like that angel knew what she was doing after all.
Oh, I think she still does. They tell you she whacked the heck out of Derek.
All right, that's my kind of angel. You know what else this means, don't you?
Yeah, yes, I now have a phenomenal ending for my article. Oh, not a minute too soon.
Which is completely great. But I wonder if maybe the real reason our great-grandparents didn't get together was so that we could.
Are you still thinking about that move to L.A.?
Yeah, I'm kind of rethinking my rethinking.
No, Brady, no. I told you, you have to put your work first.
Why? You didn't.
What do you mean?
Who left New York without finishing her do-or-die article just to come after me?
Okay, I didn't exactly come after you.
Oh, you completely did. You put me first, which is huge. So no, I am not running away. Neither are you.
Actually, you should run away. But just for an hour, I have an ending to write.
Finished?
Yeah. Now we just wait for tomorrow's paper to see if I have a future as a writer. No pressure.
Well, in the meantime, you want to decorate a Christmas tree?
More than anything.
Summer sun, but also winter.
Congratulations, Miss Staff Writer.
I couldn't have done it without you.
No, you couldn't have done it without our great grandparents. Oh, and the angel, of course.
Merry Christmas, Brady.
Merry Christmas, Susan.